now we are with Dr. Ikram Hussain, who is working as a professor in the Department of Physical Education with Aligarh Muslim University. So we understand your specialization and the area of interest is in biomechanics, and we happen to, you know, listen to your interesting research on biomechanics, sir, in the sports sciences. So we really wanted to understand, sir, how much biomechanics today has been contributing to the improvement in the performance of the athletes.
Sports biomechanics is one of the area of the sports sciences. It deals with the techniques or the movements of the individual performers. The any falls, any lacunas in their movements, any sorts of movement fault which may cause or hinder his performances. What we do is we analyze that particular movement and bring about changes in the movements so that the optimum performance can be enhanced. So, right in India, we don't have such biomechanics that are working in specifically with the techniques or technical aspects of any, till my knowledge goes, to any other any associations or any sports. But at international level, there are a lot many of sports associations, and even the individually, there are a lot many of athletes who goes their performances, analyze their performances, find out their faults, find out their lacunas, where they are being stopped by the movements. So they are being corrected. At international level, there are a lot many of applications, specifically the sports performance, because of which the performance have reached up to this particular level. But India, I don't have much knowledge about the associations or individual players, they are doing it. But whatever I have heard about, studied about in the newspapers and all, that long back, few years back, Bobby Johnson, then athletes, she had been to US to analyze her movements, long jump movement, and got it corrected, and she has improved her performance. What I have read in newspapers and all. But I'm not aware in person that there are, is there any other sports persons or any other teams which are going on this. My knowledge goes, in India, we don't have much sports biomechanics who are working individually to the sports performers, with the athletes.
So do you think the sporting bodies which is there in the country or the federations can actually, you know, adopt and understand this important aspect and take it forward to the athletes?
Associations or the government, whoever is responsible, they should go and they should find out people, they should associate people, they should associate researchers, researchers and research centers, so that they can improve. Not only sports biomechanics, they should associate with other sports sciences, or they may adopt a sports science center with all these sports biomechanics, sports physiology, sports psychology, sports anthropometry. They all can be combined, they all can be associated and get their performance evaluated and get best treatment to the athletes so that they can improve their performances.
So today when we are looking India to be a sporting nation, and yes, there is a lot of investments which are going into different sports. So it makes good sense of investing on a very evidence-based sports science, which is biomechanics. And as you said, that it talks about the movement of any athlete into any particular sports. So yes, the movement is important in any sports, and investing some kind of a resources, time, would definitely help an athlete to improve the performance. So on the sidelines of this third national conference on sports and education, where the focus is on empowering the skills and women empowerment, so how do you see women actually performing in sports in India?
I don't say women empowerment. I said we should have a man empowerment.
Too much of women empowerment.
No, too much of women. They are already very high, especially if you look into the Indian sports. You go to archery, the women are going ahead. If you go to shooting, the women are going ahead. If you go to the fencing, women, Indian women, we talk about Indian women. I mean, the Indians, in the last Olympics, our Indian women hockey team have really done well. That way, I think they are really, women are really of the same height, of the same level. So we should have this, as a sports person, as a whole, we should take care of all of the sports. And they need a specific special treatment. All right. sports persons, they need a special treatment so that they can, everyone can improve. Anyone who comes into that particular level brings laurel to the country.
So we really look forward, sir, your research on biomechanics really going out to the professional athletes and even reaching out to the grassroots level to make a big change in the country as a sporting nation in the future, sir.
Sure, sir. Thank you very much. We hope that we'll be able to tie up with the associations. Wherever physical education and sports science, any all researcher should tie up with the associations and federations and the government so that everyone can contribute to some extent to the best possible performance of the Indian athletes.
Thank you for joining us and sharing your research and the experience with us, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Physical education is one of the areas whereby it develops a team spirit, irrespective of which gender is participating, which caste is participating. It has no entry of those things.
As long as you feel you are right, you need not worry about what the world says, because the day you will win, the very same society is going to appreciate you.